This week, Marjorie Taylor Greene, along with fellow conservative Republican Representative Matt Gaetz, reiterated that she is absolutely going to force a vote on opening an impeachment inquiry in the House of Representatives into President Biden. And Republican strategist after Republican strategist are now out there warning their party, this is very stupid. In fact, several different Republican strategists speaking to several different media outlets all use the word stupid when describing this potential impeachment inquiry. It started with longtime GOP strategist Susan Del Perio, who said, quote, "It's stupid. It's completely made up. They don't have anything. This is not about impeachment for cause. This is a political stunt, and I have a feeling it's going to go very badly for Republicans." Again, this is a Republican strategist saying this. This is not some liberal out there. This wasn't me saying it. These are people who love the Republican Party, who like the Republican Party, and support the Republican Party. And Susan Del Perio is out there saying, this is stupid. Nevertheless, Marjorie Taylor Greene says, quote, "I'm demanding it. I am so serious about this because I know the evidence is there, and I'm so disgusted and embarrassed for our country that we have such a corrupt president that we have allowed to remain in power and that have colluded and conspired to cover up his crimes." Here's the thing. On January 21st, 2021, which was President Biden's first full day in office, do you know what Marjorie Taylor Greene did? She introduced her first set of articles of impeachment against him. So the opinion of somebody who's literally been trying to impeach President Biden before he was even president for a full 24 hours doesn't mean much to me, nor should it mean anything to the rest of the Republican Party, because these are the rantings of a lunatic. But again, as I said, this was not the only Republican strategist who said the idea was stupid. You also had veteran Republican strategist Mike Murphy, who did go on MSNBC, and he said, quote, "Politically, it's an incredibly stupid idea. But we suffer in my beloved GOP from kind of the banana republic wing. Many of them are elected, particularly in the House, and they are a minority of them that have been direct mail fundraising, operations to feed, and kind of this echo chamber and stuff. Can hardly wait to do something like that because it's in their own narrow interests. It's not in the Republican Party's interests if they want to not get wiped out next year and propose in November." So I love what he's talking about here too, because this was something that I hit on in a video earlier this week. It's the fact that all of these Republicans that are pushing for it, specifically, you know, Marjorie Taylor Greene and Matt Gaetz, those people are in safe Republican districts. They're in districts that do hate Biden. So they have nothing to lose, right? Their party is not going to punish them for doing this. Their constituents will actually reward it. But when you take these other Republicans out there in a swing district, maybe those who even flipped a seat from blue to red in this last cycle, they're terrified of this because they know it's going to come back to bite them next November. And that's why they're getting pissed off at people like Green and Gaetz, because these idiots are pushing it and I'm the one that's going to pay the price even though I'm against it. But, oh well, they've dug themselves into this hole. And rather than accepting the lifeline that most Republicans in the House are throwing them, saying, don't do this, they're rejecting the lifeline. And by God, they're going to keep digging themselves even deeper. Best of luck with that. Ring of Fire has fresh content 7 days a week. So if you want to be reminded about it, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Hit the little bell to be notified every time a new video goes up.